But I have painted this white now, and these white, and I have gone and selected all my colours. So I'll take you through those colours there once I've done my mix. What I'm using is, yet again, art resin, and I'm using 80 mils of both A and B, so the hardener and the mix. So I just put these together. Let's get them right out. So what I will do is, you know, I'll scrape this out and I will fast forward. So what I'm going to do is, I'm not going to do equally because there's some colours I want more. Just pouring these out into the cups. And geez, I'm an idiot. I didn't protect one side of my board. Ha 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 ha. Okay, right. I've just realised I didn't protect that section of the board and I've dribbled on it. I can clean that up afterwards. Now, what I do have is I've got some resin left over still. And the colours that I'm using, these are all Pivo colours. I have no idea what the difference they mean, but I have a turquoise. Blue cobalt, cobalt blue, electric blue, and silver. So these two are a metallic style. I'm just going to come around to the other side. Okay. These are liquid. I thought I'd give these a go over top of the, instead of the, hang on, mixing sticks. I thought I'd go with the liquid to see if it's any better or easier to use and stir. Okay. I did try to get mica powder. So mica powder, when it's used in resin, gets rid of the translucency. It's really good, which is why I'm trying to see if this liquid one will actually not be as translucent either. Okay. And silver. If this works out well, I hope the person this is going to as a gift likes it. But we will see. Okay. So give these a stir. Make sure I don't get these mixed up. Okay. So this is the turquoise. Yep. Oh, pretty. I'm mixing it over the board. It doesn't matter if I end up with the colour on here. It does matter if I get it over on the wood grain section. That's quite a pretty colour. Still translucent, but we'll see. So this is the cobalt blue. And of course, all of this, how I pour this will all depend. depend on how I feel when it comes to the colours being mixed. This is the electric blue. So this is a metallic colour, same as the silver, it is a metallic. Got them at Spotlight. Spotlight had them on sale. I think they're clearance items, so I think they were selling out of them. Not sure, don't quote me on that one. But yeah, they were all on clearance. So whether it means that this company is just doing new bottles, new colours, I don't know. I will say the liquid colours, these tints, are much easier to mix than when I've used the acrylic paints, the water paints, those colours. I am adding more into this, more turquoise. I want this a really dark colour. I will pour a bit more into here. Okay, so my colours are mixed. I'm reasonably happy with those colours. I am going to put a little bit of clear and spread that around. Because I want to make sure that this goes all the way over. One of the things that I have been watching with YouTubers is... That one's too big. With YouTubers is that they... A lot of the artists spread the resin around to make sure that... helps the rest of the colour grab and it runs smoother. Right. And I want to make sure it goes over the sides. So quiet contemplation, quiet silence. Oops. So that resin is right the way around on everything, nicely on the edges. And with still some resin left. Okay, I'm taking that one glove off. I need to buy more gloves. If you're going to do this stuff, you need to buy your gloves in bulk. I haven't done much resin work, but I've gone through nearly two boxes. Okay, so I'm going to move these here. I have stuff all over the place here, just in case I needed it. Okay, and make sure they line up. And I will pop the initial little bubbles that came out. I reckon I might have a bit too much colour. That was over optimistic. Definitely too much colour. Alright, if I want to do that, I'm just going to trouble with when you want to work. Whoops, that's how. So these are my two base main colours, which are one in here. And I'll bring it around this way so you can actually see that's better. Just running these. Yeah. metallic through it. Definitely did too much colour. Didn't need half as much resin as I thought, but that's okay because I'll use it on those. Can you see it running? Okay. I'll put some of this blue here. I have no set plan for this. Okay, so let's put some of this. For next time, not to mix so much. I don't know whether I like the blowing or the flowing of it. Definitely interesting. Okay, I'm just going to use my little finger just to get this turquoise around the side. And this dip board is actually currently angling that way. Okay, so just got my excuse me. So when I put it down on the final time, it has to go back down that way. Get a head spin from doing that. When you want the dark colours, but I don't think I'm going to be able to get it dark colours around the edge. Is that enough? And put some more turquoise in there. A bit more up there. Do you like it? It's looking good. Just just want to make sure I don't have any solid lines. You know what? I actually love the look of that. I do. But I want more colour there. But I don't want to do. Okay. So now I'm just going to mix a couple of these colours. I'm just going to mix the turquoise and the silver a bit. This is definitely mixing it up. Okay. Just add another bit of colour to the. That is, you just keep adding and adding and adding and adding. And you can. The question is, what time do you, what at what point do you stop? Okay. So I think it's at this point I stop, apart from popping the bubbles. That's a real pinky green. Oh shoot! I knew I would do it. Okay, that one will have to be, I'll have to wipe that off when I'm done. I've got to re-level this. So when I'm finished, I'll put the camera on here, which has my spirit level on it, and I'll re-level. It's actually not looking. Just looking at where it's dripping the most. Okay, it's looking okay. Just gonna get some of these drips off here. But that's okay. I like the look of that. I don't know how well its coat shows up on there. I'll have to put a light on it. Here we go. Trouble is working with the resin, you get so much reflection from my lights. So I don't know if you can see that properly or not. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is use up the rest of this colour in an interesting little way. I did it before, like a dirty pour type thing. So what I'm, better put that down there. So I'm going to put one for each coaster. I'll just use the last of it up. Okay. Dollop of that. Dollop of that. And with Dirty Paws, whatever the first colour in the bottom of the cup is, will be your main colour. But for me, I'm not too stressed about that. I mean, my main, you know, these are mainly greens and turquoises. If this works out nicely, this will go with the cutting board, the cheese board, or whatever you want to call it. Put those upside down. That's for the rubbish. That in there. Oh, gosh. Come on, get down there. Okay. Definitely did mix too much. Got more than I needed. But at least I had the coasters there as a, I'll give these a go with that. Okay. So the first one. Tell when it's not level, can't you? And I'll just swirl this around a bit. Okay. That one's a better dirty pool. But definitely too much colour, too much resin. You can really tell when something is not level. I have blue tack under these, which gives me the ability to push and try to level. Do you wanna come on out? Okay. I'm at the end of the job. I'll use my fingers. So get these all out of my way. Okay, this one is definitely needing to go that way. That one's pretty level. Do want to sure that this, I want to bring this resin around to the edges. Okay. At what point do you start putting resin on? Half an hour ago. They're pretty cool. Okay. Those cups are kaputted. They can drain. I'll be able to use those cups again. Maybe. I'm just going to run my finger along and get the resin out. Try and get the drips. I will get to, leave that way. We'll get to and do a torch on these. Okay. Torch needs to make sure the bubbles are out. And I did end up with resin still left over, clear resin left over. Where's my spoon? I do like these wooden disposable spoons. What I've just picked up, because I'm trying to make sure I've got colour on these edges. The edges are running clear. Which is why you put the white on, just in case, but it would be nice if I had the edges or and every time you add a bit more colour, it just changes it that little bit more. And what I've just done then, pouring that colour on, has just created a line. I actually want to be where the camera is. Whoops. Okay. That's it. she says as she goes and puts some more, grabs some more colour. Okay, so that's it. I'll stop there. No more touching. Get rid of some of my rubbishy bits. Gosh, I've still got clear resin left over. I've got nothing to do with it. I wonder what that's going to do. That's just going to... That's actually lining it. I'm going to have to blow again. Whoops. That's the equivalent to putting white lines. Okay, let's just pop those bubbles. I will learn for next time when not to do stuff. Every time I do something long, I like that effect even more. Whew. Oh, how pretty is that now? That's even better. Okay. Paddle sticks, all in a cup, a acrylic glove, that resin cup's all good. Okay, so that's it. Do you want to? I want to try and save my cups, but I think the only way I'm going to do them is if I put them on the paper, they end up sticking. If I do this to them, they will, fingers crossed, end up sticking to the wood, which is the paddle pop, which is probably a bit easier to peel off. Okay, so that's it. No more touching. Gloves are off. Come back. Hey, Siri. 30 minutes is up. Let's have a look. Oh, okay. It's a lot of resin everywhere. Okay, so now what I'm just doing, it's all looking... This one's looking a bit, where's my tweezers? Flung them earlier. This one's actually These aren't going to be any good. These are not level. That's, they're only test pieces anyway. But they've actually ended up pretty, so who knows. Okay, so main aim of this look is to come around, have a look to make sure it's not really draining too far any one direction. It's gonna throw that torch on it. Liking the look of this. But now what I'm doing is, this glue is now fairly, not glue, the resin's fairly firm. So I'm just removing it from the underside just to make it a bit easier when it comes to pulling that off in about 3 hours' time. I'm going to be pulling this off, pulling the, it'll be set enough. Rightio, so there it is. I am, don't do that, I'll miss it. I'll just pause this, stop this, and I'll just bring you down closer. Okay, so now we're posted. So this is the two coasters. Oops. Out of bubble. So here it is, it's too late anyway. Okay, so this is the two coasters that I poured. Actually, there's, you can see a bit of a sparkle to them. But this is the cutting board, or the cheese platter, or whatever you want to call it. So you see how I'm saying this is pretty, the white here, which I'm not sure whether having the white, whether I should have left it timber or not. But what I've done is I've grabbed the drips from underneath. But what do you think? I reckon it's quite pretty. Rightio. So when I come back, I'll be removing the tape. And going from there. But yeah, I actually do like that effect. It's actually quite nice. And hopefully my recipient likes it as well. But anyway, see you shortly. Okay, it's only been 2 hours. So here we go. Sorry, I'm a little bit tricky to just unveil that way. Okay. Look at that mess. So 2 hours. This is what it looks like. It's got a bit of a nice sweeping look to it. Coasters don't look too bad. Bit of a lip. Oh, definitely more than a bit of a lip. Look at that. Okay. Come around this side. I like the look of this. Okay. So I'm just going to stop there. Back in a sec. Said I'd be back. Okay, what I'm going to do now, it's been only 2.5 hours. Two and a half hours. What I'm going to do is... Okay. Oh, crap. Just as well I did do this. What I have had happen on the back, I've actually had resin has run on it. So I need to clean that up. Bear with me while I drop everything. Hang on. Okay. Alright. I need to be able to balance this still without that resin touching anything. Okay. Alright. Just so that I can get my hands free. I've now got resin stuck on my fingers. Stuck on the baby wipes. Let's see, hopefully I can get the resin off. Baby wipes has gotten it off my fingers. So what I need to do is use it to get it off this cutting board. There. Okay. Who? Baby wipes are good for so many messes. Okay, so there we go. I've gotten it off the cutting board. Do have a bit on that edge there. Right. What I'm going to try to do, I'll throw that in the bin. Missed. Thought I would. What I've got to do is try and remove this tape. And I didn't think ahead of time. Hang on a sec. Okay, so now I'm back. What I'm doing, the reason I want to pull the tape away is I want the tape off of this edge. It also means that coming off of here, it's a lot easier if I bring it off. And boy, did I take this up well. Okay. I'm trying to work out is... the top layer of tape. You get to see how much was tape was put on the back of this. Which one's on top? That one there is on top. Oh. So this blue tape is a cloth tape. Okay, which is coming off nicely. Not the painter's tape, this is cloth tape. Tape isn't as bad as painter's tape to take off. Or it's not as bad on my hands anyway. Okay. So, just hoping you can see that. Try and do this gently. So this is where I'm wanting that edge still. Whoops. Okay. Jeez. One thing, so the resin, as you can tell, is still wet. It's not set. This is why I'm trying to do it now, while it is forgiving. It is a forgiving of me doing that. Yeah, so while it's still a little bit forgiving, what I'll do is just put a glove on. Because that's coming off quite well. The only reason why I've stopped is because I've just got the resin on the hands, which is from the... tape. There we go. Okay. Just discovered I put that on there, but that's only on the tape section. Right, I want to make sure that I'm not doing it again. Okay. So. On there. Okay. I get there and go, yeah, I'll do it that way. But and I'll put gloves on and then I go to pick it up pull it all off with the glove that the hand doesn't have a glove. Oh dear, come on, be nice to me. Got a bit of resin on my fingers now, but that's okay because I've got gloves on. Tape off. Okay. Just using the tweezers to pick stuff off. And that painter's tape has actually done really well. Oh, boots. Puss, puss. Okay. A bit more painter's tape there. Right. Come on. Oh, that's good. Did I do that again? Close call. Okay. Next bit I'm going to do is, you can see I'm struggling, is remove this tape. Just working out which one went on first, which one went on last. Okay. Oh, Boots. Here's my cat. Boots, Boots. And I want to make sure I'm only pulling up the one piece of tape. I don't want to be pulling up all three at once. Oh, actually all four, because there's another one under there. Okay. Next piece of tape was the big one. How much am I doing of this off camera? Hey, I hate tape, sticky tape on my hands. On gloves, it's all good. I'm dealing with it. It's normally something I can't deal with. Okay, now we're getting close. Top one, bottom one is the next. I'm just trying to get the tape up the tweezers. There we go. Boots, boots. Boots, boots. Just trying to work out where I am. This room is not in use very often. Okay, he's okay. He's just meowing for more food. He's been fed twice and he's got cat biscuits. Right, so he's not underfed. But he is very vocal. Okay. Right. Just okay, and there we go. Right. Got resin on that. I need to put this down on something that doesn't have resin on it. Right, here we go. I'm semi pulling this back, but but I'm actually liking the effect. And now guess who's got resin on their left hand? Far out. Right. Oh, wow. Oh, I'm so wrapped with this one. Okay, what I'm just doing now. So, here we go. How does that look? Just got a little bit of an edge on here, which I'm just going to wipe that off. But this has, the resin has come around the sides, around the back. Boots, boots. Hello. 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 Okay. I think I might actually get... That's a big conversation, isn't it? What I'm doing is just with my X-Acto knife, just getting that edge up a bit. I don't want that resin setting hard with a hard edge there. I actually need to try and get this off now while it's still soft enough. Oh, buddy. Hello. Hello. Okay. For those that have seen parts of my YouTube, and I talk about the fact that I have a cat, you don't tend to hear him. But you're hearing him now. Okay, come on. Where am I going? That side. There goes another one of the resin. Okay, hang on, here we go. What I'm trying to do, whoop, just kicked you. If I get the resin off now, there is no requirement to sand any resin off at all. Which means when this is set, which is in 72 hours, it will be set solid. And because I've just dropped another one of those, these containers are doing me quite well. I have one more part to get, which... I actually need to get that hole out. I have tape there. Hey, buddy. I think that one I'm just going to have to leave it go. I'll battle with that one when it's set. Oh, boots. Oh, well. So... there we go, that's pause done. I will zoom you back down. Final result, how does it look? Okay, it's greener. It looks a lot greener than what it does on the camera. And what I have is, I put it on my light pad so that we can really see the colour, how it comes up. But let's zoom it in. I actually like the effect of those. It is a little bit more raised on one end, or okay, but it is this. How's this? So I'm just going to try and get it to. You can't, although you saw the sparkle when it. Trying to get the sparkle to show, but it's not happening. Hang on, is that gonna, even that's not doing it. Okay, anyway, so there's a bit of a sparkle to it, but I'm really happy with it. Let's see the edging. The edges have come up quite nice. Probably a little bit missing, a little bit of color there, could go. So that's it there, and on the back. So that's really come up really well, really happy with it. I only cut out the hole there. I didn't cut it out further to match that metal ring. But yeah, I do like it. Hopefully you guys liked it. Although it's not the first time I've poured with colour, for the first time to actually do a cutting board and for it to come up like this, it's quite surprisingly easy to do for such a stunning result. I think it's all more, the colours are all about your own personal colour choice. This hasn't even been 24 hours, so it's semi-hard, but if I press too hard, I reckon I'd indent it. But 72 hours from now, well, actually 48 hours from now, I think. Anyway, a couple of days from now, how about that? This will be good as a gift. I don't know whether I'll do the coasters. I think I might, and then just say these were just additional. But yeah, I'll pop it in a bowl, put a bow on it, and give it as a gift. And hopefully, one, she hasn't seen this video, and two, she likes it. I think her liking it is probably the better one. But yeah. Easy to do. Please, if you like the work that I do with the resin, please let me know. If you want to see more of this, or, well, I shouldn't say if you want to see more of it, you are going to see more of this. I'm loving this process. Yes, it takes longer to do than a diamond, well, I shouldn't say longer to do than a diamond painting, because diamond paintings take probably longer than this. This just takes longer for a video clip, because I've got to film the whole process in one go. I've got to film the whole process in stages, and then I put it all together in one go, as opposed to just releasing one bit at a time. So thank you for watching. Please like, dislike, give us a subscribe, hit the bell, you'll get notified of any uploads I do, and thank you for watching. Bye.